Praise God, praise God, praise God, dear heart. Thank you for joining me this morning for Shalom Morning Prayer. I am your host, Evangelist King. You know, at House Shalom, we're just simply building that peaceful house for God's glory. I want to thank everybody for joining me this morning. I want to first apologize for the last week. I had a tough night the night before, and I overslept. So just please forgive me, you know. Sometimes, you know, I have a good night's rest all night, and then other time my sleep will break, in which I wake up two or three times during the nighttime. And last Monday night was not a good one. So that's the reason why I didn't come on Tuesday. And I have no way of letting you know that I'm not being able to come on. But I thank God for those of you last week who did tune in and I wasn't there. God saw you. He saw your heart, and he blessed you anyway. Praise the name of the Lord. And thank you again for your continued prayer. My health is getting better and better and better. Just that my sleep pattern at night sometimes just break. And now, especially this day, like same time, like this morning, wow, I really slept late. But praise God, I was still able to come on this morning. But again, I just want to thank everybody for tuning in. You know, before prayer, I just want to give you God's word of encouragement. And this is going to come this morning from Psalms 121. You know, Psalms 121 is a song of ascents. That is A-S-C-E-N-T-S. And when I saw that, I'm saying, let me look up that word and see what that meaning is. A song of ascent. You know, there are many foolish people who have a goal to go and climb Mount Summit or other dangerous mountains. It's just that it's like they got this conquest in mind. They just got to do it. Well, that's what ascent is. It means a climb or walk to the summit of a mountain or hill. And also it means an instance of rising through the air, which is a takeoff, a liftoff, a launch. So that is what Psalms 121 is all about. It's our ascent. It helps us to make it throughout the day. It's our climb. It's our blast off. You know, it's us soaring in the air. It's our track, our scaling, our conquest. Psalm 91. It helps us to walk through, to really to climb every mountain. Glory to his holy name. Psalms 121. So anytime you want to, you feel low and down and out, read Psalms 121. That is a song of ascent. It helps us to take off for that day. It gives us that boost to keep on keeping on. That's Psalm 21. And you know, we all need that from time to time. No matter how strong we think we are, it's going to come a time and point in each and every one of our lives. We're going to need that ascent. We need that takeoff. We're going to need that encouragement, that bless off, and continue to do the things of the Lord. That's why the Lord told us, you know, don't get weary in well doing. Don't get weary. Because the devil will try to make us get weary. Why? Because a lot of times, like for instance, you know, you give unto the Lord. And at the moment, you know, you might not see no fruit or increase in that. But you look at your neighbor who ain't even serving the Lord. And it seems like they are being financially blessed. You turn around, they're getting something done to their house. They're getting a new car. They're getting a promotion, a job. And you know, they're not even serving the Lord. And you look and you be like, what in the world? And the devil tried to get you to be discouraged about that thing. And get you to be wearied about that thing, to get you to stop being obedient to the Lord. But then, dear heart, go read Psalm 121. And again, remember, you know, it's our ascent, it's our takeoff. You know, it's how we soar amongst things that's not above the circumstances. You know, a lot of times people ask a person, how you doing? Well, I'm doing great under the circumstances. You're not supposed to be claiming to be under no circumstances. You're supposed to be above that those circumstances. So Psalms 121, a song of ascent, it helps us to soar above our circumstances. And it gives us that encouragement. Remember, it's Psalm 121 is our conquest, you know, where we soar. So Psalm 121 verse 1 says, if, remember that it starts off with if. So that shows you that some people are just not going to do it. They're just not going to do it. You got a choice to do it or not. That's why I say if. If I raise my eyes to the hills. A lot of people don't. When they start having bad circumstances, they're not going to raise their eyes to the hills. They're not. No, they, again, under those circumstances. But David said, if I decide to do it, because the choice is yours to do it or not. If I raise my eyes to the hill, from where will my help come? From where will my help come? If I raise my eyes to the hill, from where will my help come? Amazingly, David is asking himself that question. And a lot of times we have to ask ourselves a question too. Again, especially when our circumstances are not going the way that we should go, we should take Psalm 121 and say, if I raise my eyes to the hill, from where will my help come? Talk to yourself. And then you answer yourself in the Lord. And verse 2 say, David said, my help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. He had to remind himself. We have to remind ourselves, Jehovah, where our help comes. Our help always come to Lord, comes from the Lord. He's the maker of heaven and earth. But before we realize our help comes from him, we have to lift up our eyes to the hill and ask ourselves, where will my help come from? That's right. My help comes from the Lord. He's the maker of heaven and earth. 3 say, he will not let, your foot, my foot slip. He said, it say, your guardian, my guardian is not asleep. See, the Lord will not let our feet slip, and he is definitely not asleep. Not like us, we require sleep, we need sleep, but he's never asleep. He will not, dear Lord, he will not. You hear what he said? He said, he will not let our foot slip. Because why? Because he never sleeps. He sees and knows everything. Everything. So when we remind him, he already knows. And a lot of people think, well, Lord, do you see what I'm going through? Oh, yeah, God, see. He's wondering what you're going to do about it. Are you going to lift up your eyes to the hill from which all your help comes and realize that he is the Lord. He's the maker of heaven and earth. He will not let your foot slip. He is your guardian. He watches over you day and night. Oh, dear, I thank God. I thank God for watching over me and my family, not only my physical family, but I pray for my spiritual family, all of us, day and night. Because we truly don't know what God is guiding us from. Now, a guardian is someone who guards us against something. Something that's going to cause us harm. And God, he does. He guards us against Satan and his demon, who 24/7 trying to get to us, to destroy us, to kill us. Oh, dear Lord. But the Father, through Jesus Christ, by his Son, Jesus Christ, by the Holy Spirit, do not allow the devil to do it. So he is our guardian. 4 said, no, the guardian of Israel never slumbers or sleeps. I mean, when we slumber, when we sleep, he never. I tell you, he always got his eyes on us. Doesn't matter where we at. We'll be deep down in the valley, he still got his eyes on us. You know, when he had, you know, just like we who got children, when they were babies, we may be busy doing something, but we always have our eye on our child. Always. Child never is out of our eyesight because we always watching for that child so that child wouldn't harm themselves. Well, our Father is much, much more better parenting than we are. Behold, this should give you great encouragement this morning. I know it gives me great encouragement to know that Adonai, God Almighty, is our guardian, and that guardian never sleeps or slumbers. You know, the rich people of this world have bodyguards, which are their guardian, but they got to sleep and they slumber. They can't keep a watchful eye on them. But our Heavenly Father never sleeps or slumbers. Again, he always got his loving eye on us, protecting us. Remember now, a guardian protecting you against something, against somebody, against something. And again, our Heavenly Father protecting us against the evil one. Five say, Adonai is your guardian, is our guardian. At your right hand, which is our right hand, Adonai provides you with shade. He provides us with shade. The sun can't strike you during the day, or even the moon at night. See, he takes care of us, dear heart. You thought it was that job that's taking care of you. You thought it was your husband that's taking care of you, or your wife, for those husbands who haven't found a job yet. No, it's Adonai. It's the Lord God. He takes care of us. He provides for us. You know, whenever we have a good husband, a good wife, whenever we have good children that take care of us, we have a good job. Remember, it's not them. It's Adonai, Lord, who provides those things for us to be taken care of. And that's why we should always give him thanks in everything. Remember now, this is a song of ascent. And this is our takeoff every morning. You know, read it. You know, it helps us to soar above our circumstances. It's our climb. That is a mountain that we're going to go over because we're looking to the, our eyes are set and look to the hill where all our help comes. It comes from the Lord. He's the maker of heaven and earth. He will not let our feet slip. He is our God. He never sleeps. He provides shade for us. You know, I understand that because I remember as a little girl, you know, back then, you know, parents tell us go play outside all day long in the sun. And when you come to a tree that got shade, oh, it feels so good to be protected from that sun. You know, well, Adonai, he's our guardian. He's at our right hand. He provides us with the shade that shade means a comfort. And you know who the comforter is? That is the Holy Ghost. So our Father in heaven through his Son Jesus Christ has given us the Holy Ghost, who is our comforter, our comfort, our shade, provide us that rest. You know, again, you under that tree and the shade, you feel so good, and you just sleeping, relaxing, in comfort. That is the Holy Ghost. He said, even the sun cannot strike you during the day. Not even the moon at night. Not even the moon at night. You know, God just loves us so much, dear Lord. We have so much to be thankful for. That's why we shouldn't be complaining about nothing. Complaining about nothing. Just give thanks to God in everything. You know, we can't give thanks for everything because everything that happens to us is not from God, not of God. But the evil one. But while we in it, we give God thanks. The heart. You know, one thing God don't like is a complainer. I don't even like being around people who complain. God did not like complaining. You know what happened to the children of Israel in the wilderness? Complain. I mean, just think. Now, the Holy Spirit was not given then so that the Holy Spirit could be in them. He was with them, but not in them. So therefore, they saw with their eyes, and they could touch with their hands, and they could feel with their feet. But the main thing, they saw with their eyes the miracles of God, how Adonai was at their right hand, how he protected them, provided them shade. You know, during the day, the sun could not strike them, the moon could not strike them, their enemies could not harm them. He would form in the daytime between the enemy and the children of Israel, he would form a gigantic, I don't know, like a blizzard or something, And the same thing at night, where the enemy could not come where they were. I mean, that miracle they could see with their eyes. Now we read about that miracle, but they saw. And then when they came to the Red Sea, they saw when Ananias poured the water, and they walked on that dry land, looking on their right, right side, looking on their left, seeing the water. Probably saw the fishes in that ocean. They saw. You know, they still complain. I mean, and then all the millions of people didn't have nothing to eat, and he provided them manna, bread sent from heaven. That's what it means, bread sent. But it wasn't called manna, because manna means bread sent from heaven. He sent them bread from heaven. And they ate. And they still complain. They complain. And you see what happened to them. Most of them were destroyed. Those who were not destroyed, they walked around in circles. Can you imagine walking around in circles for 40 years? Jordan was right around the corner, but they couldn't see getting there because God confused their footsteps. 40 years. That shows you when you complain, you're going to keep going around in circles. So if you want to stop going around in circles, then that means stop complaining. Be thankful to God in everything. 7 says, Ananias, who is the Lord, will guard you against see all harm. He will guard your life. Oh, Jesus, thank you. He guards our life. Do you not know the danger that we in, and we don't even know we are in that danger? Now, Satan can only work through yield vessels. He has so many yield vessels this day and time, he's working through. You know, the media is showing us how Satan is working through yield vessels, with innocent people just being killed. Children are being snatched, kidnapped, killed, organs taken away, sold, you see. Dear Lord, God protects us, and then he protects our children. That's why my heart goes out for children who don't have godly parents that prays for them. Because that's what happened to the children these days. That's what happened to the children these days. Lord, at this day and time now, young children from the age of 8 to about 15, 16, been kidnapped, and their organs been taken, killed, and so that their organs are being harvested and taken from them to be sold in the marketplace. Lord, this is happening. You see, hear tell of all these missing children. Later on, they've been found dead. Mm-hmm. That is what's happening to them. Every now and then, the media get hold of their organs being missing. Behold, we need to continue to trust the Lord. Keep our eyes, look unto him where all our help comes, so that our children can be covered, our children can be protected. You know, I do deliverance sessions, and I get people to send me messages all around the world. And it really disturbs me when it's a mom with children, and maybe they're not married, or they was married. And it seems like their only aim is to be married. That really bothers me. I said, Lord, you know, that really bothers me. Because their aim is to get married. I mean, with all their heart and might, they focus on getting married, looking for that man, looking for that woman. And then when they think they found the one that they think they found, they end up marrying them. And now they still complain because now they married them. No, dear heart. If you're a single woman, single man too, your aim first should be to have that close, intimate relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ so that you can be a covering for your children so that Your children will see Jesus Christ, action and reaction through you. That should be your aim. That should be your heart, is to live that godly lifestyle before your children so that they too can grow up and know the Lord so that they can be guided by Adonai. But know your heart on getting a husband or wife. And a lot of times, you know, they end up choosing someone and they end up having sex before marriage, you know, sampling the product before you get married. And what happens when you do that? Well, you don't realize now Satan's going to work in one or the other where they're never going to marry you because they don't sample the product. Then they have a tendency to go live together. So Satan, you don't sample the product and you see where that he or she ain't the one. I don't like the way they act. You know, it's just a mess. That's why I did what we should keep our eyes and look unto the hills when we're our help. Trust in the Lord. Even with relationships, those who are not married, even those who are married, still trust in the Lord. Your husband and wife might not be acting or reacting the way you want them to act or react. Well, you let them see Christ Jesus act and react through you. And that may change them because a godly woman will sanctify her husband. You know, trust in the Lord. Trust in the Lord. So again, 7 say the Lord will guard us against all harm. All harm. Harm that we know about and harm that we don't know about. And I'm telling you, there's some harm that we don't even know about. He guards our life. 8 say, and not with God, our coming and going from now on and forever. Ain't that good? Now, in the natural, you're going to have a bodyguard, but they ain't going to be with you now and forever. Now, I mean, wherever you are, they right there. Your bodyguard got a limit, got a boundary in which they can guard you. They cannot come so close to you. Like, for instance, when you're in the bathroom, you're taking a bath, they can't be there. No. The Lord God, I will come in and I will go on. He do it from now and forever. That is good news, y'all. I just thank God. I just thank God. God protects us. So, dear, this is a song of ascent. ASCEN. T.S. Psalm 121. Ascent means a climb, a walk to the summit of a mountain or hill. The incense of rising through the air, which is a blast off, soaring, take off, a launch. It's our encouragement. Psalms 121. And we thank the Father for his word of encouragement. Let us know that his eyes are forever on us. As he said in his word, he never leaves us. He definitely never forsakes us. He is with us unto the end. You know, our loved one can go with us just so far, but it's going to come a time where we're going to have to leave this earth realm, and go into the heavenly realm to be with Jesus. And only Jesus Christ, by his Spirit, can be with us. Family, nobody can be with us. You got that boundary. But there's no boundary for our Lord Jesus Christ. But don't you think all the days of our life we should seek to please him? Because he never leaves us. He never forsakes us. He's with us until the end. He got us. God, our coming in. God, our going out from now and forever. Praise his holy name, dear Lord. Glory. So I thank God for this encouragement, this lift off this morning for our day and every day. So we'll pray now. But Father, in Jesus' name, I just want to again thank you for this opportunity you've given me this day just to say thank you on this earth. opportunity to carry forth your will. Well, it's not my will, not our will to be done on this earth, but it's your will. And I know we have our plans and have our ideas, but Father, I learned that my plans and ideas is secondary to yours. Your plans and your ideas is most important. What you want us to do this day. And it's always, I've learned, it's always in bringing glory to your Son, Jesus Christ. Father, I thank you, Father, for the few in number, Father,
thank you,
that you allow us to come together to encourage each other in the Lord. But we live in a day and time that we need to be encouraged.
You
need to encourage one another in the faith. And we say thank you, Lord. Thank you for your grace. And Lord, I thank you, Lord. I found, Lord, when I was a little girl that you are my guardian. Even as a little girl who didn't even know you, but you knew me. You guided me from that evil, from those evil ones. Was not even aware of evil ones, that there was such thing as evil one, but you still guided me as you continue to guide. In spite of my parents not serving you, you still guided me. That lets me know that some grandparent of mine down the line prayed for my parent and prayed for their grandchildren and their great-great-grandchildren. And you always kept those prayers in your nostrils. I thank you, Father, because you protected me. Many times you protected me. Many times the devil as a little girl tried to kill me, but you kept me against that harm. You guided my life.
Thank you, Lord.
Why? Because you're such a graceful and merciful God. My heart goes out right now for every child who don't have parents to pray for them, Lord. Parents who are careless with their life, living sinful life. Living a life where they're refusing to attain you in their knowledge. I pray for those children. Keep them as you kept me.
Yes.
Guard them from the evil one, Father.
Yes.
Father, when that voice leaves them off on the wrong track, Lord.
Bring them back. Cool.
Thank you for sending the angel to bring them back. Many times, Father, I read that you worked through animals, a bear. You have worked through a bear. You worked through a lion. To bring that child back on the right track in protecting that child.
Glory to God.
Father, I thank you. Because Father, if you can't find a human being to work through, you will work through an animal. And I thank you, Father, for bringing those little children back on the right track.
Glory to
because
God.
They all have a plan and purpose. And bring a glory to your Son, Jesus Christ.
Thank you, Father.
Protect them, Lord Jesus.
Thank you for another leading.
Protect them, Lord Jesus.
Thank you for every
and I thank
you. Your Lord, if you praise, we give you all the
glorify you and magnify you.
We respect everything. We cannot do anything without
you. We just give you praise and glory.
Helping us, protecting us.
We thank you for
everything you've done. Thank you for
we give you praise in everything.
By our right hand. Thank you.
Well, you know what it's been.
Thank you for always being there for us.
Glorify you.
Yes,
we magnify you always.
We can't
well, you
without.
Are
thank
worthy
you
to be
all the glory and honor and praise. Everything blessed.
Thank
Jesus
you.
Jesus went to pray for us.
Thank you.
Jesus went to me all
thank you for your faithfulness. Thank you for your faithfulness, Lord.
Your
thank you, Lord. Many times we have not been faithful, but you remain faithful to us, and we say thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Glory to God.
For your grace and mercy.
Thank you. Thank you.
Father, I'm reminded of your Son, Jesus Christ, on this earth. When he healed those 10 lepers. And as they went, as he told them, go show yourself to the priest. As they obeyed his word. As they walked in their faith. Gradually, the manifestation of the healing manifested. But Father, I'm reminded only one came back and told you thanks.
Thank you. Yes.
So that tells me, Father, many of your children, you've done such amazing miracles.
Yes, you have.
In their lives. You have protected them.
Yes.
Everything belongs to you.
Your eyes are forever on them, and they have yet to say thank you. Father, we today, this morning, is saying thank you for everything that you have done for us. Things that we know that you have done for us, and even things that we don't even know you've done for us, we still say thank you, Father.
Thank you,
Father. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name. We say
thank you for everything.
We say thank you from our heart. Thank you. Thank you, Lord, for keeping us. Thank you for preserving us. Thank you for keeping us all the days of our life. Thank you.
Pray together.
For the enemy meant for harm. You turned that thing around, Lord, and used it for your good. We say thank you
for it.
Thank you, Father, for confounding the way. Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
Glory to your name.
Thank
you.
We magnify yourself to you.
Glory to you.
We lift your name up high. We cannot do it without you. Glory to your name.
And thank you for everything that you're doing.
Pray, Lord,
in Jesus'
name.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Never lose another forsaken.
Thank you.
Glory.
Helping us all to come together for prayer today. Thank you for protecting us.
We praise you for your holiness.
Thank you for empowering
us with
your strength.
Thank you for
covering
us all
with the better teachers. Thank
you for protecting our health. Thank you for
empowering
us. Thank you for empowering us with your strength, your spirit.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you for enabling us to say
thank you. Thank you for the voice you've given us
to
verbalize our thanks for you, Lord Jesus. Thank you.
Thank you for everything you've done for us.
For every little thing that you have done.
Thank
you. Every big thing you've done for us.
For everything you've done for us.
We say thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
We're not selfish people.
We need to do everything
we say thank you
at all times.
Thank you, Lord.
Praise
what you have done.
Praise, Lord, as an honor to
is doing
praise
and
you
will
to come
do
together
in our
to
life.
Worship you.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank
you
for everything you've done for us.
Thank you,
Lord.
Thank you,
Lord.
Thank you,
Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Thank
you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Helping us maintain our deliverance. Thank you for everything
in
that
Jesus.
Thank you for delivering us.
In Jesus' name.
Praise Lord.
Thank you.
Jesus.
Thank you. Thank you.
Praise the Lord.
We don't want to be known as a complainer.
Hallelujah.
We don't be known as seeking your hand all the time, but we want to seek your face. We want to see your face, Father. We want to know you and the beauty of your holiness.
Never leaving a
purpose. Many of your children are just seeking your hand.
They
want your hand, what you can do for them.
But
we want you. We want to know more of you, have more of you, know more of you, Lord Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
That is our strength. That is our life, Father. That's how we survive in knowing you, Father. Through your Son, Jesus Christ. By your Spirit, Father. In Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you,
Jesus.
Thank you,
Lord.
Thank you,
Lord.
Thank you, Lord. Forgive us, Lord, for only seeking your hand.
Thank you, Lord.
Forgive us.
Forgive us. Praise the Lord.
We seek you, Lord. Knowing the beauty of your holiness.
Praise the Lord.
Knowing your heart. We want our heart to become your heart. Yes, Lord. Glory.
Always awake to protect.
Glory.
Thank you.
For holy name. Praise Lord King.
Lord,
my
King. Thank you,
Lord. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
Merciful to us.
Thank you. Thank you,
Jesus.
Thank you.
Thank you, Lord God. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise His holy name, dear Lord. You know, we all need to just ask Lord to forgive us. Because we really think about it, we seek more for his hand. That means what he can do for us instead of seeking his face.
Yes.
You know, when we seek his face, we all may get his hand. Yeah, that's who he is. But if you really look at it, we mainly seek his hand. Our prayers is concerning what he can do for us. You ever notice that? Our prayers are really selfish about us. You ever notice that? Like what he can do for us. Instead of what we can do for him.
Mm-hmm.
When we pray, Lord, let me do for you, automatically, he does for us. But I deal with God's children all the time, and I see that they are very selfish. Instead of seeking his faith, they seek his need.
Yes.
what God can do. God give me this. Like a little child. 4-year-old grandchild. She always wants something selfish. Hey. I want to, you don't get me a toy, get me a gift. That's a baby Christian. That's a person who haven't grown up, a baby Christian, always seeking God for what they want. It's like a baby. Give me, give me, give me, give me, give me, give me. You know, babies don't give. They want you to give them. Give me, give me, give me. That's a baby Christian. But when you grow up, you ain't no baby Christian. It's what you can do to help others. You see, so we need to seek his face. When we seek his face, we automatically got his hand. Praise the living God. So I thank God for his encouraging words this morning. We lift up our soul to contend this good fight of faith. It's a fight. A beautiful fight for our faith. To encourage us in knowing that he is our guide. He's always at our right hand. He guards us against all harm. He guards our life. He guards our coming, our going, from now and forever. His eyes are never asleep because he never slumbers. He never sleeps. Praise the living God. His eyes are always on us. Thank you, Lord. Glory. Anyone want to share based on the message, just feel free to share it in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Glory to his holy name. Again, I want to thank everybody for coming out. Again, those who tune in later, I apologize for last week. Again, at night, my sleeping pattern is not back to normal, where I sleep all night. I have a tendency some nights just to wake up during the night 2 or 3 times and break my sleep. Last Monday night was one of those nights. And I just, you know, overslept for Tuesday morning. And I have no way of letting them know that I won't be able to come on. So I want to thank those who still came on. If I don't come on, I say by 8:10, then that means that I'm not coming on. Let's put it that way. 8:10, I'm not coming on. And I have no way of letting you know. But that's what happened on last week. Praise God, you know, my sleep, Roger changed the room, and I noticed when he changed our bedroom to this other room, it's bigger, it's like I got more space, and it's like I can sleep a lot better. Because before, the other room was like a small room, you feel like you feel closed. You actually put your bedroom furniture in there, it's like you're in a tight knit place. And I just kept waking up during the night, in the morning hour. I like, what in the world? And I would go in the front room and sleep, which is a bigger place. And so when Miriam and my grandbaby moved out, they got their own place. And Roger switched bedroom to the big room. I noticed that I felt like I was a much bigger area. And I slept a little bit better. I said, wow, why is that? I can't explain that. I said, well, thank you, Lord. It helped a lot. But my sleeping prayer at night, I don't sleep all the way through yet. Every now and then I sleep all the way through. Every now and then. So just keep me in prayer about that. I would like, when I go to sleep at 10, I like to sleep all the way to at least 6 p.m. That's 6 a.m. And that'll be it. But I keep waking up, keep breaking my sleep. But praise God. Nevertheless, God is good. He's good. Thank God. Because there was a time in heart, I was so sick that I remember for 2 days and then there were 3 days, I could not sleep at all. I mean, I could see a person end up going crazy that way. If I didn't know Jesus, I would have went crazy. I was sleeping, but my eyes would not go to sleep. That spirit of insomnia was attacking me. But I kept praying, thanking God, my Father, for giving me blessed sleep. I refused to listen to it by telling my doctor so he can give me sleeping pills. I said, no, devil, you're not going to get me deeper and bound into bondage by taking those sleeping pills. No. And I kept thanking my Father for blessed sleep. Hear my eyes wide open, couldn't sleep. sleepy, but couldn't sleep. But I kept saying, thank you, Father, for blessed sleep. Thank you for blessed sleep. I kept on. And I refused to take those sleeping pills. And I mean, I did that twice, one time for 2 days, one time for 3 days. And I kept on pressing through. I know that spirit of insomnia had to go. It had to go because it saw it was not going to give in to it. And my Father, he blessed. Blessed sleep. Glory. See, I had to persist in my faith that no, I was not going to take those sleeping pills because it would just make matters worse. It made me addicted to and dependent on those sleeping pills. And that was an open door for the spirit of insomnia to enter into me. It would have been the open door. I said no. And I'm telling you, in 2 or 3 days, my eye, I was going crazy. I said, Lord, I see person go crazy like this and don't get no sleep. But I kept pressing, kept believing God, thanking him for blessed sleep. And like I said, that spirit left and the Father gave me blessed sleep. Glory to his holy name. So again, dear heart, thank you everybody for joining me this morning. And I also want to thank everybody who comes on Shalom Morning Prayer. You really blesses my heart. And also thank you for financially blessing the ministry as well as my personal life. You're going to hear me say that a lot because it truly is a blessing. I thank you for hearing God for us and then being obedient to the voice of God. So you know, we can hear God's voice, but do you not know it's up to us to be obedient to his voice? So thank you also for being obedient unto God in that area. And I just want to say thank you. So remember, those of you who listen on the archives, come and join the live corporate prayer of Shalom Morning Prayer. I know you listen on the archive. Now, some of you can't because you may be at work, because there's a way around everything. But you know, circumstances may dictate that you can't. But again, we can do what we want to do. Come. You know, if you just have you tune in, just listen, just mute yourself. Just mute yourself, you know, and just listen. That's still tuning in, you know. And you can pray. When we pray, you can pray within yourself. Especially when you be at work, just pray within yourself. You know, when I was at work, I would love to have found a morning prayer like this because I would make it my devotion every morning while I be at work. I have my headphones in on my phone, and I'd be tuning in to this prayer. And I'd be at work, and I mute myself, but I'd be letting God's words go into my hearing, the prayer, uplift my spirit. I would be just listening. I would have one of my microphone in my ear, the other one out, so I can be aware of my work environment. There's a way around everything. I would just need to ask the Holy Spirit. He'll give us a way. But come to corporate morning prayer, Shalom morning prayer, Tuesday mornings at 8 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. Go to the website at radio.holyghostfire.us and you see instructions on how to download the Zoom app on your cell phone or your computer in which you can tune in. And it'll tell you to, once you download that app, you click the app and click join and key in Shalom Pray, and then you'll be able to join us in Jesus' name. All right, dear heart. Everybody, you stay blessed. And again, thank you for taking time out this morning to join us. And stay blessed in Jesus' name. Shalom, everybody.
Shalom.
Shalom.
Shalom.